Hello, friends. So, to continue with my obsession, understanding experience and understanding consciousness, today I want to revisit something that Max Planck said. Max Planck, one of the pioneers, or we might say fathers of quantum physics, said you cannot get behind consciousness. What did he really mean? So right now, of course, in the scientific literature, one of the most open questions in science is the hard problem of consciousness. What's the biological basis of consciousness, and how do neural correlates of experience explain consciousness? So I'll do another video on the difference between the neural correlates of experience and how they're different from the correlates of non-local awareness. I'll come to that later. But now just let's look at what we call the attempt by scientists to explain qualia by the measurement of qualia or neural correlates of experience. And what I'm saying right now, that the neural correlates of experience are themselves experiences, and that we cannot ultimately get behind consciousness, as Max Planck said. So let's unpack this. Okay. First of all, qualia are inherently subjective. Qualia are defined as subjective qualitative aspects of conscious experience. Actually, they could be of non-conscious experience too, as in dreams. You know, you see scenes and colors and sounds and all that, but let's keep unpacking. By their very nature, qualia are intrinsically tied to first-person perspective and cannot be fully captured by third-person observations. Once again, as Max Planck stated, we cannot get behind consciousness. This suggests that any attempt to measure or quantify qualia will inevitably involve subjective experience. Also, what scientists refer to as the observer effect. When scientists attempt to measure neural correlates of consciousness, they're engaging in an act of observation that itself constitutes an experience. The process of measurement, while whether through brain imaging or other techniques, requires conscious attention and interpretation by the researchers. So many neuroscientists have stated, to identify the neural correlates of conscious experience, we need to identify patterns of neural activity that are specifically associated with experience. This identification process is inherently experiential. What about the role of introspection and subjective reporting? Studies on neural correlates of consciousness often rely on subjects reporting their subjective experiences. This introspective process is itself a form of conscious experience. The act of describing or quantifying one's qualia involves generating new qualia related to the act of introspection and reporting. Then think also about the recursive nature of experience. Any attempt to analyze consciousness and its experiences scientifically involves using consciousness to study itself. This creates a recursive loop where the tool of investigation, conscious awareness, is also the subject of investigation. Neuroscientist Dimasio points out that the mind and its consciousness are first and foremost private phenomena. This privacy, or privacy, however you want to pronounce it, means that even objective measurements are filtered through subjective experience. The act of measuring or observing neural activity becomes part of the overall conscious experience of both the subject and the researcher. The knowledge gained from these measurements influences subsequent experiences and interpretations, creating a dynamic interplay between measurement and experience. So this always points to the limits of reductionism. Attempts to reduce qualia to purely physical processes face significant challenges. So, of course, Chalmers coined the word hard problem of consciousness and expressed that there's an explanatory gap between physical processes and subjective experience. This, of course, implies that even if we could perfectly measure all neural activity, we would still be left with the experiential aspect that cannot be fully captured by physical descriptions. So, in conclusion, the very act of measuring or studying qualia and neural correlates of consciousness is itself an experience that generates new qualia. We cannot step outside of consciousness to observe it objectively, as our observations and measurements are always mediated through conscious experience. And this aligns with Max Planck's view that consciousness is fundamental and that we cannot get behind it. The scientific study of consciousness, while valuable, is ultimately an experiential endeavor that cannot fully explain, that cannot fully escape or explain the subjective nature of phenomena it seeks to understand. Okay, so the hard problem of consciousness is a non-problem. Please let me know if you agree with this, whether you have any arguments against it. And always, you can connect with my digital twin on digitaldeepak.ai and we can continue this conversation. Also, Digital Dharma is available in bookstores right now. Thank you, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Always grateful for you indulging me.